out checking the roads out.
As the weather deteriorates, Dave assesses the 5-mile dirt road, the only way in and out of the mine.
I'm a little worried about getting our equipment out of here, getting people out of here before the snow falls. We're in a avalanche zone. Avalanche Alley, they call this. We've got to pay attention to that.
6 feet of snow already blankets the slopes above. With more forecast to hit tomorrow, the entire mine site is at risk of avalanche. The steep slopes of this valley are known as a terrain trap. When an avalanche hits, there's nowhere to run.
Look, Dan Dempsey showed me pictures of avalanches coming right down to this road.
We were mining up here in the winters.
You mined in the winter?
Yeah, it was the most dangerous thing I've ever done.
Holy cow!
I mean, we'd watch avalanches come out of this, and we had one come right behind us. I thought I was going to get buried.
And oh my goodness. You can see. It's got to be 30 feet, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Holy that wasn't here yesterday. You know, it was cold last night, froze, get a little bit of moisture, freeze-thaw action, you end up with this. I mean, you look around, look how steep this valley is. We got a lot of snow up top. You know, we get an avalanche or something, blocks the road, we're stuck in here. But we got a lot of work to do, try to beat winter.
Time to kick ass. Our season's coming down to ours. Casey's going back and forth like a crazy person. We're running hard.
Back on the mine.
I got a short window to get as much pay out of this sunlight cut as I can into that eagle.
The team runs the plant all out at 200 yards per hour.
I'm trying to kind of feather the material into this plant, because we don't want to put a big jolt of weight at once on the rip the belt.
Thank you, Andrew. Paying attention, I appreciate it. I mean, Andrew's fed the plant 100% correct. Now that we're feeling it, doing good, doing real good.
You know, Andrew has definitely grown for his first season with Team Turin. I've never seen somebody show so much interest. He wants to learn.
I've never operated an articulating haul truck before.
There's a lot of buttons in here.
We'll figure it out.
Nice and easy, Andrew.
All right, I got this now.
There you go.
Now I just need to learn how to operate a dozer. I believe by the end of this, I'm going to be a lot better miner than I was on day one.
Being the new guy in such a small team, is awesome. It's been what I've always wanted. Everyone has to do their part for things to work, and that's what I like.
I came from a very hardworking family, and that's who I am.
Dave took a chance with me, bringing me onto this crew. Being a trusted crew member, it's an accomplishment.
Dude.
Yeah, go ahead, Casey.
Dude, I think I just clipped a rock. Clip something.
Let's go back or some. I hear it. Oh, oh, oh. He's got definitely a hole in the tire. It must have got right in there. He must have hit something.
Like, I didn't see anything. Just bam, hit me.
Well, we ain't got a tire with. If it's got a hole in it that bad, I mean, it's blowing out pretty good. Yep.
Hey, Dave.
Hey.
There you go. Nope.
That's a hell of a hole. Look at the air coming out of there. Why don't you go get on the phone? And I don't care if you wake somebody up. We got to find a tire guy, because this is our last hope. If we don't have a front tire on that, we're not running. This is not what I need right now. That's the one piece of equipment I can't do without. I mean, without a haul truck, we're done.
The end might be nearer than we thought.
Tell me what you got.
Nothing.
Oh, man.
We had nothing. We can't haul pipe.
I mean, I can't run that material up with loaders. That's not going to do any good. If we run what's left of the pay pile, and let's just pack it up. End of the season, boys. When that pile's gone, we're done. You know, this isn't really the way we want to end the season on a flat tire, but I think it's time.
Yep, I agree.
You know, the snow's right there. We've been warned, and I feel really proud of what we've accomplished. We're in Alaska, and if you guys, you figured it out, you managed it, you conquered it.
I'm proud of everybody.
Amen.
Yes, we are.
It looks pretty good in the box.
Yep.
We'll clean it up, get it up to Shelley. See if the sunlight cut put us over the top. I've been doing this for a while, but I have to say that this year stands out to me as one of the most amazing accomplishments. We've overcome Alaska.
If it's there, great. If it's not, we tried.
It's time for the crew to discover if its epic Alaskan gamble has paid out.
Hey, Dave.
Hey, Shelley.
What's up, guys?
Woo-hoo!
So you're carrying quite a heavy backpack
well,
there.
Well, that's a good sign.
Bring it over?
Yeah.
Sweet.
Easy. Oh. Easy.
You know what, you guys, 3 months ago, I didn't think I'd be here. I didn't think we'd have this
good Lord.
Bag full of gold.
I didn't think we'd have any gold at all.
28.
Come
There's
on.
30. Come on.
Drum
There's
roll,
33.
Please.
Come on.
36.
Whoa.
47.
Whoa. Here we go, here we
48.
Go.
Woo!
Yes!
All right. We're over.
Woo!
Coach.
Woo!
Yes!
That's a big money.
Keep going,
Shelly.
Keep going. Oh, big money. Come on. 60.
Woo!
61.9, we are in business.
Woo,
here we go.
Talking about.
It's a beautiful sight.
That is good right there.
Freaking outstanding.
Yep.
Their high stakes gamble in the sunlight cut pays out a record 61.9 ounces.
We worked our asses off for that.
You know, starting when we started and to come up with 463 ounces, it's a hell of an achievement.
Yes.